No. Game got the good forest. I like the forest vibe of running through the forest in this game. Pretty good. Jesus. Accidentally double tap. Man. This area used to have a shitload of people. Until for some reason, their reason for them leaving the alpha, either to find another server or they got tired of, the grind? I don't know. Could have more wildlife, though. Sometimes it just kind of feels like things are dead. Like, right now I feel like I'm the only one in the world. No animals, flies, trees. This guy should get patched. In combat. Maybe you can stop. Yeah, there goes a car. Well, there we go. He makes some arrows. Go ahead and just make some wood ones. Why not? Boom. Well, that's crafting up. Check out this cave. Killed two wolves that were right here. Would run out of food. I don't know what's in here. First time. Yeah. Alright. Follow this out. Make him regret it. Out of spam. Stay organized. Get in there. We ain't got no torch, so. More wolf. A lot of fucking wolves. Jesus fuck. Kind of like something was running up on us. They can't get. Probably not the greatest idea I've ever had. Jesus Christ. Can't see shit. Guess we don't know. I don't trust the darkness because in my experience it's there's no floor. Be like, oh, there's some light over there. Let me go get the light. You know what I mean? And then I head over there and guess what? What's that? Me falling through the floor or falling down a hole. this the exit? Oh my god, I don't even know where the exit's at. Jeez. Wanna go explore a cave, Eugene? Yeah, I'll go explore a cave. Get lost in the cave. We need a torch. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome in. The last day, right here, for Pax Dei Alpha 2 testing. Yep. Played every single day since the start of the test as a solo player. Let me tell you, we built a grand ruined fort, which took a lot of clay. And a lot of stone. Got halfway with the building. Took 2 days of building with stone and clay. Then, with the issues of the clay spawns, the devs found it that they'll increase the spawns and distribute on where those spawns would be, which helped out in the final staging of the building. As well as building some forges. Okay. Was pretty good. We dabbled in with mining, chopping trees, gathering berries, mushrooms, black, cotton, you know what I mean? The tannery, the blacksmithing, the armorer, the weaponsmith, and the leather workbench, all the way down to the forging up the iron, copper, what is it, lead or tin, as well as got as far as melting the glass for the brewery, the distillery for the beer and the potions, the food, the rotisserie cooker, whatever you want to call it, you know what I mean, and the tannery rack and the loom. All right, we as a solo player, we try to dabble in almost everything to see what this game has to offer, okay? You know, we killed boars, rabbits, deer, wolves, and bears. Don't know if I said one of those twice, but A, we try to take on, what is it? Archers, mages, I want to say wraiths, zombies, whatever the hell they are. And went into a cave that seemed to be a den down in the location of the down zone. Looked like a den of wolves. Nothing but wolves in there. A lot of wolves. And we retreated because we didn't have a torch and it was dark as hell. We was making our way down. You can see our character. We're dabbled up in some armor. Didn't get too far within the armor. We made swords, and let me tell you, spears. And we've made a lot of spears. Probably over 70. Failed more of the times than none. Probably would have made more than 70 if we would have actually completed every single one of them. But the crafting system is brutal. Now, this game, it's kind of grindy in the sense of the crafting system. I consider myself a hardcore gamer, and I played the beta of Ark Survival Evolved. Now, that game was true grindy survival to its heart, let me tell you. That was rough. But this game, the grindiness comes from the crafting system alone. Let me kind of walk over here and explain a little bit to it. So boom. So we got not too far with the armor, with the leather workbench. So the leather band and the leather string, the other green stars, right? If we were to make one of these, we wouldn't get XP. We would have to make a leather bracer, which is an easy yellow, and or leather shoes or leather leg armor, which is orange. Orange, you have a more of a chance to fail, and sometimes you'll get partial ingredients back. Other times you won't get shit back, and you'll lose the ingredients itself to make it all. Okay, and the red, you'll get the most experience, but I would have to say orange feels like a 75% chance to succeed. And I think red's like a 45% chance to succeed. Maybe 50-50. It's like a coin toss, you know what I mean? Who really knows? But it gets really brutal as in the aspect as rawhide. You have to turn hide into rawhide, which takes about 20 minutes on the tannery rack. Then you have to turn the coarse hair. Yeah, keep it on there. Got to turn the leather, the string. You make that using rawhide. So not only do we use rawhide twice, then the iron buckles and the iron studs. You have to forge up mine from the, what, impium, however you want to call it, right, with the mining. That takes about an hour, for 20. But then first you have to have the melt out this the wood to get the charcoal, right? That's about 10 to 20. I think it's 10 minutes for 20 charcoal. So when you think of it in whole, okay, it's pretty grindy when it comes to the crafting system. But while, you know, you got your iron smelting up while you're getting your wood turned to charcoal, there's a lot of other things to be done with, right? And as a solo player in this test, I was dabbling through all of it, and within the amount of time that it takes for the iron to smelt up, the wood to turn to charcoal, the food to be prepped, that amount of time allowed focusing onto other items within my little encampment that I could have been doing, which when you break down the time-consuming mentality of it like that, it's not bad. Not bad at all. As well as, you know, I mean, it is a MMO, so there are other players running around. In the early start of the alpha, there was a shitload of players. Down here to the last few days, at least on this server that I'm on.
Wow.
It's a ghost town. It's a ghost town. Probably because many of the majority of the players have already wrapped up. But we're going to test it out to the fullest, you know what I mean? That's from start to finish. Damn right. You want to start something, might as well finish it. The limited time, I want to get as much experience that I can into this game. Learn the ins and outs for the moment anyways. And we sure did. Dabbled all the way to the brewery. You know what I mean? Or the potion making, the drink, the food. Been a blast. Been a blast. Looking forward to every other alpha test that I can get a part in. Damn right. It's pretty good. The armoring system with the layer of armors you can do, pretty good. You know, I really wanted a two-hand sword or a battle axe, but we were stuck at the damn spears and we couldn't get enough XP to get past the spears to make a two-hand sword or a battle axe, which then I can show you how far we actually got. Boom. See? We were stuck making this sturdy spear. I've only saved a few. I was tossing them all on the ground. Only wanted the battle axe. I think the battle axe was a long sword. One of the two. Made quite a bit of spears. Got some spears down here. Spears. We got more back through here. Spears. Clothing. And you click on it. Swords. More weapons. Swords. Spears. You know what I mean? So been a pretty good test so far. Definitely has. I like the building in the game. Building's pretty good. Definitely is. The feel of the building feels pretty good. Definitely does. Definitely can't wait until the next alpha test and or beta test. Whichever one comes first. I do know that there is a lot of issues that they do need to address. I would like to see that some more of the food items can be stackable, because the food chunks, like the boar, the deer, the rabbit chunks, and all that type of chunks, only stacks to 5. Definitely like to see at least 20, maybe 50. 50 is probably pushing it. But, and then simple chest and the second tier chest, increase the item slot just a tad, please. Devs of Pacdia, please. Storage in a game like this, it's huge. It's huge. Storage in a game like this, it's huge. It's huge. Very huge. I'm probably not the only one saying it. Storage in a game like this is huge. Not only do you have different... Okay, let's break through it. One, you have the raw resource you must gather. Two, you have items needing to craft, which are used further down the line for other items. Thus, there are other items that you, in order to craft, require other different type of items that you then have to craft using raw resources. You know what I mean? So you get a bulk hold of needing for storage. Okay? You need storage. A lot of storage. And the simple chest is trash when it comes to storage. And then you get to the second tier chest. You do. Okay? Take a look. Boom. That's a simple chest. Holy shit. What am I going to do with that? That's like, you know what I mean? Just enough to like help you gather stuff and then come back. And then boom. Like this. This is the size. Or at least maybe lose these right here. These bottom tiers. And these three lines. That should be a simple chest, to be honest. Or at least a full two lines for a simple chest. You know what I mean? And then maybe, you know what I mean, just add another line for this chest. Because storage in a game like this, it's going to be probably the most important thing that the devs are ever going to add into the game. It really is. But overall, from my feedback of this game, pretty positive. It definitely is. Now, I played as a solo player, you know what I mean? And it is an MMO, so there are other players. You can have clans. And the aspect of the party system, which is pretty unique, you know what I mean? In a sense of, I guess not as unique as I'm thinking. But, I don't know. I was thinking about something else, maybe. But, planning the party. I don't know. Two unique systems that are important in any MMO. But you can recruit people and have a larger homestead, which then, you know what I mean, the more players, the more you can gather. But in my experience, the more players you have, the more storage you need, you know what I mean? Because if you are having one dude work on the wood chopping and building as a lumberjack, and then you have the other guys out chopping the wood for this guy to level up at the crafting station, you need storage. You know what I mean? So storage is important. But overall, pretty good. Pretty good. Definitely going to be jumping on more of the alpha test, if able, here down the road for Pacdia. Looking forward to where this game heads in its direction. Definitely will keep you posted. Damn right. Definitely will.